Is there truly no God? First and foremost, I kindly request you to temporarily let some of my ideas step into your brain, judge them, and then, doubtlessly, it is your choice to keep or throw them. Well, imagine that we have two books. The first one is a bit thick, and the second one is extremely thin, and both of them contain the same exact amount of data. Then it is obvious that the intelligence which was involved in making the thin book is superior to the thick book's intelligence. Whenever we have a dense amount of data and a smaller storage medium, this must imply a sort of intelligence. Cool. Now imagine that we have a 700 terabytes of data, which equals rows of books lined up on top of each other from the Earth up to the moon, more than 500 times. You see this 2 terabytes hard drive? Imagine an amount of data stocked in 350 hard drive like it, and it was possible to store it in a storage medium sized a needle tip or smaller. Then immediately arises this very question: what is the incredible intellect behind this process? However, this is exactly what scientists have recently started to endeavor. So, instead of storing data in hard drives, Blu-rays, DVDs, CDs, etc., they have decided to explore this storage medium sized a needle tip. I mean the genetic code DNA, which is located inside the nucleus, which is located in the cell. If the scientists succeeded in cramming a tremendous amount of data inside the DNA and were able to secure them in a safe place to last for thousands of years, would any rational act irrationally and guess that this might happen by chance and randomness? No sound mind human would say that at all. Now focus. Over time, scientists tried to unzip the DNA. Lately in 2003, they made a big stride into cracking the DNA and decoding the data there. But a bigger stride has taken place in 2012 when bioengineer and geneticist at Harvard Wyss Institute have successfully cracked the DNA storage and have discovered that 1 gram, just 1 gram of the DNA can store 700 terabytes of data. The ex-evolutionist Dean Kenyon, professor of biology at the University of San Francisco, has referred to the huge storage capacity in a cubic millimeter of the DNA.
You can calculate the number of bits contained in tightly packed DNA material, let's say that would fill 1 cubic millimeter of space, as equaling 1.9 times 10 to the 18th power bits. Now that number is, by many orders of magnitude, vastly greater than the storage capacity of the largest computing machines that we have.
Also, Francis Collins, the ex-atheist and the director of the Human Genome Project, said in his book, The Language of God, the human genome is 3 billion letters long. Just to read it aloud, day and night, would take 31 years. By the way, when we talk about the DNA, we're not talking about normal information. No, we are talking about a type of information. If implanted into a living cell, we'll convert this information to a living organism. That's what led the senior atheist, Sir Anthony Flew, the professor of philosophy at the University of Oxford, the world's most notorious atheist, who authored more than 30 books, which had a great impact on people, to change his mind and return to belief in God in 2004. And he authored his book, There is a God, in 2007. And maybe this is the suitable time to listen to this verse of the Quran.
أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ
Yes, being created by no creator is always rejected by the innate mind, let alone creating ourselves by ourselves. That's why scientists and many others have turned out to be certain that the possibility of this huge world to come out by chance and randomness is zero. It may happen that an ink bottle dropped on a white paper to draw a nasty cat. It may happen. But these scattered ink drops will never write your full name, nor will it guide you to your home place. First of all, because this goes totally against the innate logic, I mean causality. Second, it is due to the fact that randomness and chance have a bound restriction. Let me tell you how. Claimed that monkeys typing randomly on keyboards, given enough time, could eventually type out the complete works of the Shakespearean sonnet. Therefore, life could also happen by chance, an idea which had great impact on many people. Later on, the British National Council decided to get in and did the experiment. Brought up 6 monkeys, locked them in a cage, trained them how to type, and after 1 month of the experiment, this was the result. The monkeys had produced 50 typed pages, but not a single correct word. Actually, the lead male spent most of the time bashing on the keyboard, while the others spent most of the time urinating or defecating on the keyboard. Hence, Gerald Schroeder, professor of nuclear physics, MIT University in America, took the initiative and studied the possibility of the monkeys randomly typing the 18th Shakespearean sonnet alone, which has almost 488 letters, and came up with the following. The possibility is 10 to the power of 690. Taking into consideration that the universal bound probability law said any possibility exceeds 10 to the power of 150 is considered to be impossible. Finally, I clearly and openly encourage you to take the right step and return to your origin. Thanks for watching. Wonder why you're so alone, worry, and when faith begins.